Dear students, in today's module, we will be discussing role of controller under the data manipulation. So, you know that we have discussed that how the communication is performed within the CPU. So there is a RAM, and then the RAM is connected with a bus to the central processing unit, and data is coming to the CPU and going outside of the CPU, but within the limited setting of RAM or the main memory. However, how the communication will be performed outside of this world, like when we perform to communicate with keyboard, with a printer, with the scanner, with the mouse, mic, speakers. So all of such communications will be handled with different procedures. And in today's lecture, we will be mainly focusing on role of controllers. So although we will be discussing some other things in the next modules as well, like direct memory access, handshaking, and communication media and communication rates. So what is controller? Controller basically communicates between computer and other devices. And in case of PC, it is permanently mounted on the motherboard, and sometimes it is flexible to attach or detach from the computer. So it connects via cables to peripheral devices. For example, you might have seen the controller who, for example, connect to your printer. So there is a dedicated controller that is attached to your motherboard, to the motherboard of your computer, and that communicate with the printer. And similarly, there are other controllers which communicate with the scanner, with the keyboard, mouse, etc. And they are themselves a small computer having their own CPU because they have to do number of tasks. And controller translates the messages back and forth. It tells the computer that, okay, the printer is ready now, you can send the print, or no, there is a problem in the page, there is no page in the tray. So all of such handling with the device to the computer, the main communication guy, the main communication device is the controller. So originally, there were each controller worked for only one device. However, nowadays, we are going to make such controllers which can be used for multiple purposes. And those controllers actually are attached on one side they are attached on the motherboard, and on the other side they are giving a port on the back side of your computer where you can attach your device. So you might have seen some of such ports like USB and FireWire. So universal serial bus, that is basically in which you can plug in many devices. So for example, you can plug in your keyboard, your mouse, but previously it was not possible. You could only connect mouse to another port and your keyboard to another port. So how it works? So basically we have a CPU here and main memory. You know, this is a bus which is available for the transfer of data. And these are the peripheral devices like modem, CD drive, disk drive, monitor. So all of them have their own dedicated controllers. And these controllers, via using this bus, because they are also connected with the bus, they communicate with the CPU. So for example, if there is a signal from CD drive that the CD has been ejected or has been inserted, so that signal will be passed to this controller, and this controller using these wires will communicate with the CPU. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned about controllers, why we need it, and how they help us to communicate with different devices, and they have different ports. Initially there were dedicated controllers, and nowadays we have formed some universal controllers like USB and FireWire.